The ironical and sad fact is that even if some dreams, goals, or aspirations are fulfilled, happiness disappears quite quickly as the mind starts changing new goalposts. A new job, a new house, a bigger car, etc. On the other hand, joyfulness is the unconditional commitment to be happy each moment, to have fun for the moment. Despite the problems and the challenges of life, no matter how insurmountable they seem to the mind. Now, what is the difference between joy and your happiness? Joy is your expression of happiness in whatsoever mood you are. Happiness, it occurs when your wishes are fulfilled, short-lived. Why? Your wishes are short-lived. Once if they are fulfilled, you will enter into the arena of new wishes. Suppose I want to buy a house. I bought it. It is single bedroom. Then, no, this is not sufficient now. It is insufficient. Let me have a bigger house. I'll go for a double bedroom of my choice. I feel happy once again. And after few years, once again I'll see it, it is very small even. Then I'll have to go for a double bedroom or a villa or something, a duplex or something. So till I get that, am I happy? No. No, I have a house, no. I fulfilled my wish, no. That is only one wish is fulfilled. There are n number of wishes. So that is happiness. And joy is what? Irrespective of your mood and your emotion, periodically or for certain period, whatever you are expressing, that is called joy. Action, activity, or expression, that is joy. So, on the other hand, joyfulness is the unconditional commitment to be happy each moment, to have fun for the moment. Despite the problem and the challenges of life, no matter how insurmountable they seem to the mind, we cannot cross, we cannot come, insurmountable, we cannot cover, we cannot come across, we cannot overcome, surmountable, right? So, however they are, very many difficulties are there. Even then, if I can express myself in a good mood, right? That is called joyfulness. That is how these two are different. This joyfulness cannot become unjoyfulness. Happiness may become unhappiness. See the difference again. Joylessness, no, the word is not there, should not be used. Joyfulness is only the one thing. Because joy is inexpressive. And having no joy cannot be expressed because it is not there. If it is there, we can show it. Because not having joy is empty. How can I show that? So, joylessness is not there. And unhappiness is there. Please remember it. Joy, there is no opposite. Happy, there is an opposite. Right? Please, displease, we have it. So, it is the promise that the body makes to the mind to indulge in playfulness moment by moment and thereby give relaxation to it. During these periods of playfulness, triggered by a plethora of physical activities like dancing, singing, playing, and laughing, physiological and biochemical changes take place within our body that give us a sense of well-being that completely alters a negative outlook towards life and its challenges, replacing it with confident positivity. So what is joyfulness? To express your happiness, I showed, or to show it. Action is there. How do you do it? You dance if you are happy. You sing if you are happy. You whistle if you are happy. Right? You play if you are happy. See how many things are there. Dance, sing, play and laugh. And by that, your physiological and biochemical changes do occur within you. Happiness may not bring all these things because it is only a feeling within you. It is not the expression of that. Joy is expression of your happiness. And if at all you are expressing it, you are dancing, you are singing, you are whistling, you are playing, you are laughing. With that, your physiological requirements are fulfilled and your biological requirements also fulfilled, right? And these will completely change your outlook from negativity to positivity. And also you can face the life challenges positively, right? And a moment by moment positivity will be there within you if you express your joy. And in many software companies and BPOs nowadays, they have adopted certain methods. Suppose there is a drumming. You go on drumming. Means you are doing something where this brain is not useful. By that you got getting relaxation. And then when you are drumming and that fellow is also drumming, there will be a competition like, and you enjoy it. And then lastly, with a beat somewhere, when you beat him, you get laughter. See the thing, how sequential it is. You have started that to get a relaxation out of that busy work, mental work. And you are drumming it. Then one more person, when your colleague, he comes over there and he finds you were beat. And he too takes a drum and he too go along with your beat. And he is also beating, you are also beating. Then you have seen, it is just like a competition, like, okay, let me beat him by this beat itself. And you start, and he also thinks, let me beat him. And then both are in a high distance range of beating, you are beating it. And you surpassed his speed and you get a laughter. And because he is, what we can say, defeated. No, he is not defeated. He doesn't feel defeated. He will also have a laughter. Means your complete body, mind and everything got relaxed. And again you go back to your work. Many therapies have been brought into this line. Why? Because that is needed now. Because it is needed now. So that is one therapy I told you. Therefore, in laughter clubs, members develop a positive conditioning of joy. By laughing together over a period of time, clapping in rhyme, in rhythm, chanting ho 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 ha in unison, and positive affirmation like very good, very good, yeah, 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 hip hip, hooray, hip hip, hooray. What are all these things? Do they have any meaning in it? No, simply chanting something. And while you are chanting, your legs may be going right and left, right, left, right, left, right, like that also you may go. And you may put your hands up, or you may relaxingly, you may twist your hands. This is all a package of laughter club, laughter yoga. Means simply standing still, it is not called laughing at all. So the brain develops new neuronal connections to produce happy neuropeptides and hormones in the body that rejuvenate the members. All this exercise, this laughter, they mentally work, and the neuropeptides will be secreted, and your nervous system very effectively functioning. Not only that, hormones will also be secreted, and then your body is fit. and rejuvenated. That is the effect of the laughter. And laughter yoga means a chance, an opportunity to laugh, makes all these things. And so it is called as laughter yoga. Finally, laughter yoga rectifies shallow and irregular breathing. If 100 children are examined for their breathing practices, out of this 100, I am very sure more than 50 students may not be having a very healthy or regular breathing practices. Music, singing, vocal singing. See, Lata Mangeshkar, still we say, we take her name, veteran in singing. She is still alive. Means, I don't say she should die, no, sorry. Why? She was simply singing some thousands of songs she has sung. And we enjoyed her songs. But while she was singing, how much exercise, breathing exercise she has done. That counts. That is the secret of longevity of living. That is the secret, exactly. So, it is no harm when you are sitting in a park, go on singing. No, sir, if people hear me singing, what do they think? Again, LKK you are. Log kya kahenge? No, it is for your good health. Go on singing. No, sir, they make mockery of me. Don't bother for it. That gives a very regular breathing. You will be knowing where to stop and where to gain the speed and where to slow it. These are all controlled. Breathing will be controlled when you are learning the music, singing, vocal singing. See, every medicine is there with you readily, but you ignore it, right? And laughter yoga will also teach you how to have the breathing, and it controls, it rectifies breathing defects, and it will give you a real healthy breathing habits within you. So, according to Dr. Otto Warburg, a Nobel laureate, one of the main reasons for falling sick is the lack of oxygen in the body's cells due to incorrect breathing. So, let us laugh together and get the oxygen back into our cells. There are many skin diseases, many, psoriasis, they call it, and they call it itching. Many names they put, ringworm they put. Why these two occur? Because my skin is not healthy enough. Why my skin is not healthy enough? Right? And so, simply apply turmeric, apply your neem. It is the remedy only. Then prevention, are you taking preventive activity there? Sir, what prevention I can take, sir? It is a contagious one, no ringworm, it has come. And ointments are available, I will put it. That is only again prevention, only remedy. Prevent it. You have to see the oxygen supply to every part of every cell of your skin. It is properly regulated. It should get its own requirement of oxygen. You see to it. Then how to do it? If the yoga guru says do your pranayama. The name itself is pranayama. Means every part of your body gets rejuvenated if you intake the correct quantum of oxygen into your body. Many diseases are occurring, even itching of your body or anything, sneezing or coughing or having fever, whether it is minor or major whatsoever, It's all due to non-supply of oxygen into your body, required oxygen. There is no wonder, earlier we used to think, why should we buy water? We used to think, because it is freely available in the nature. Now we are buying 15 rupees a liter water we are buying now. Right? If it is colored water, if it is tasted water, something is been added over there. We call it as a Coke or some Coca-Cola or Miranda or something, and we are buying it for something more. 1 liter 37 rupees or something, we are buying it. There is no wonder if you find some joint somewhere, oxygen joint. Means what? When I feel suffocated, let me go and have that mask to my nose, breathe it over there and come back. There is no wonder, it may happen now. Right? Let us not go to that consequence. Let us not welcome that consequence. Then let us laugh to our lungs full. Right? And that is laughter yoga. Don't wait for the chance. You catch that chance. I said yoga means chance, opportunity. Opportunities do come. No. Opportunities are to be taken. You take the opportunity of laughing. So that is a major medicine to heal all the minor and major defects in your body. Right? So let us see what is the exercise over there. Exercise is a very little thing that you have to read it carefully, and you have to again choose some words, B5, given below in jumbled form are the subheadings. For every paragraph he has given some subheadings here, and you have to arrange it in a proper manner, and for each and every paragraph you have to give the title there. These are the titles, suggested titles. These are in jumbled manner. You have to arrange it, and here how you arrange it, it is up to you. And you have to read it, you have to understand, and you have to put it. For para 4, one something, for para 6, something has been given, 2, something, 1, something. Likewise, for every para, something has been given. You have to arrange it and you have to put it in a correct manner. Whether it is correct or not, you have to check by yourself and with the others. Teacher is not going to correct yourself because you are the master of yourself. Right? So, only we can make you understand the passages here and how to name it. Because I did not name you. It is your name, you have it. It is your title, you have it. Likewise, here also the title, you have to make it by yourself, enjoy it. Because enjoying is reading and studying and learning.
If you like this video, please give a thumbs up. Please subscribe to our channel to get more videos on CBSE syllabus.